Hey guys, this is Sonali, the Melodramatic Bookworm. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you all the weird bookish things that I do. BookTuber Meera Nair came up with this brilliant idea. Thank you, Meera, for this idea. Guys, if you like watching videos about books, then you should definitely go check out Meera Nair's channel. I promise you, you will love the content just like I do. So let's get started with my list of weirdnesses. That didn't come out right. The first weird thing that I do is that I read multiple books at once. Now, I don't mean at the same time, but in parallel. If I'm not following any challenge, then I'm reading one paperback or hardcover copy, one Kindle ebook on my Kindle device, and one on the Kindle app on my phone. People usually ask me, how do you keep track of all the plots? And all I can do is stare at them and ask, what do you mean? It makes my life exciting. The second weird thing that I do is that I cover all my physical books. I have the habit of carrying a paperback or hardcover in my bag wherever I go, irrespective of whether or not I'm going to read it. And you know how a girl's bag can get. There are tons of things in there which can tamper with a book. So to avoid that, I cover my book in newspaper and write the title in sketch. People say I've got OCD. They have no idea how close to the truth they are. The third weird thing that I do is that I buy more books. It might seem harmless. You might ask, what's wrong in buying more books? But when I already have 220 books, including the paperbacks, the hardcovers, and the Kindle versions, the hoarding becomes weird faster than I can say sale. And this list doesn't include the ones that my husband already has. The fourth weird bookish thing that I do is that I read while I eat. While many people watch TV and check their phones while eating, I prefer to read. It's my kind of entertainment. It could be a physical copy or on my Kindle device or on the Kindle app on my phone. But I love learning about fictional lives as I try to sustain my own. Yes, there's a lot of wrestling to make sure that nothing gets spilled on the book or the device. But I'm a neat eater, so I move heaven and earth to make sure that the book remains neat. I also like to chomp on something or drink something while I'm reading apart from meal times. This happens especially when the book is particularly engaging and I have to have something or I'd have a coronary. Of course, reading while eating is said not to be healthy, but who said I'm a health-conscious bookworm? I'm merely a melodramatic one. The fifth weird bookish thing that I do is that I will not buy the Kindle version of a book that I really want. That's right. If I find a book really interesting and the physical copy is expensive, then I will not buy the Kindle version of it no matter what. Instead, I'll wait for the price of the physical copy to come down or for a time when I can actually afford it. Case in point, a man called Uwe. The first time I checked the price was about a year ago, and the price then was about $350. The Kindle version, however, came on a very hefty discount a number of times, 99 rupees only, but I did not buy it, yet now I am a proud owner of the paperback copy. Okay, so this has to happen to a lot of bookworms out there. While I'm reading a book, I get in the story and roam around with the characters. I have no idea what's happening around me in the real world. There have been so many times that I've burned the milk vessel and I found something odd only because I've started coughing because of smoke in the house. People get angry at me and tell me that keep your head in the real world. What do you get by reading books and all? I keep swearing I won't do it again, but what do you know? Us bookworms are a stubborn lot. The seventh weird bookish thing that I do is that I use anything and everything as bookmarks. You know those markers that come with t-shirts that you buy online? I use those for bookmarks. And supermarket bills. And boarding passes. And magnetic bookmarks. And sticky notes and whatnot. I use literally everything. or figuratively. Go figure. The eighth weird bookish thing that I do is that I close a book for a while when a conflict arises. I'm not good with confronting conflicts. So when I come across something in a book that I'm not comfortable with, I prefer closing that book, giving it some time, giving myself some time to deal with it, and then get back to whatever's happening in the story. The last book that did this to me was Mudbound. With all the racism that was depicted in the book, it sickened my stomach and made me put the book aside for a few minutes while I handled what was going on inside of me. And the first book to do this to me was 1984. What a book. The ninth weird bookish thing that I do is that I maintain a quote book. I either write down the quotes that I like or mark them with sticky notes on the page where the quote is. And if it's the Kindle device or the Kindle app on my phone, then I just highlight them. And when I'm done reading the book, then I transfer all these quotes manually to a separate dedicated quote book that I have. A lot of other people do this too, but for people around me who see me sitting down and dedicatedly taking out the time to write all these quotes, it seems like a weird and inconsequential thing to pay so much attention and give so much time to. The 10th weird bookish thing about me is that I write down my reactions to what's happening in the story and to the characters in the story in a dedicated book. If I'm angry at what's happening in the book or at any character in the book, then I write it down. God bless the soul who reads my reaction. If I'm happy about something in the book, then I write it down. Even the author would feel ecstatic to see the emotion with which I've written my reaction. If I'm sad about it, then I write it down. Either way, I feel pretty strongly, so when I write down my reaction, it helps in reducing the murmuring in my head before I go ahead and complete the book. The last weird bookish thing about me is that I cannot abandon a book, no matter what. However bad the book might be, I cannot abandon it halfway. This has put me in a number of difficult situations, forcing me to read books that have been absolutely preposterous, making me rant and shout. But I simply cannot abandon them, no matter what. I know this will be the death of me, but I have the hope that there's a far higher number of amazing books than the non-cyclical ones. Everyone has their own quirks, and these were mine. I'm sure we all have some in common, because all bookworms do. Let me know in the comments below what you think of these weird bookish things, and if you share some with me, I'd love to hear from you. If you like what you see, please like this video and share it to spread the word. And don't forget to subscribe. I have a lot planned in terms of bookish pleasure. Click on the bell icon beside the subscribe button to receive notifications as and when I upload new videos. As a side note, I am hosting a big giveaway on Instagram where you stand a chance to win two books. One is John Green's Looking for Alaska and a beautiful notebook from Papercraft. All you have to do to participate is follow me there and follow the rules that are specified in the post. Here's the link to the post. Giveaway ends once I reach 600 followers. Thanks for watching till the end. Until next time, keep reading, keep watching, and add melodrama to your life.